بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين الحمد لله my dear respected viewers we begin by praising Allah سبحانه وتعالى for this opportunity for us to continue with our Q&A session every Friday after the Jumu'ah in prayers at 2 p.m. We pray that Allah bless this session and make it a reason where Allah forgive any our sins and answer our prayers, and may Allah protect us from all difficulties, trials and tribulations in dunya and akhirah. Amin. Ya Rabbal Alamin. So inshallah ta'ala, we will enter into our first question of today. This question is asking, hi, I am a post-operation MTF transsexual. I have a question to ask since I've always wanted to be female, but I know I can never be. I have been digging for sources to the root of the problem, and it seems to be tracing to me being a male sperm merged with a female egg rather than a female sperm merged with a female egg. I do not know if one should believe in the next life, but I know there is. Do you think in such a scenario, if I want to be a female next life, I have to self-terminate if I know I am the male sperm? Hope Masjid Khalid can help me find the answer to this important question that does matter to me. So basically, question is saying in the first part that the questioner is a post-operation MTF. For those who are viewing, basically MTF meaning male to female. Male to female transsexual. So what I understand from this term is that the questioner has gone through an operation that he is a male, but he does an operation to remove some of his organs or some of his body parts in order to be a female. So this is what the term MTF transsexual. This is basically what I understand from the question. So the questioner goes on to say that he has been wanting to become a female, but he knows that he can never be, and he has been looking for the sources to the root of the problem. So let me begin by saying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created man in pairs, and He created man, the male, and He created the female. And this is mentioned in many verses in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned khalaqat dhakara wal untha. Yeah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the one who created the male, and He is the one who created the female. So it is the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make a person male or female. So for example, when we exist in this world, we find ourselves, some of us are male, some of us are female. And there is basically not within our choice. We do not ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before we enter into this world, oh Allah, make me a male, oh Allah, make me a female. But this is the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So as Muslims, we believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has ordained for everything. And He is the one who has ascertained and who has ordained whether a person is a male or female. So there are many things that is not within our choice. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for example, He created us with a certain color skin. Some of us are fair, some of us are brown, some of us are dark. So these are the things that we do not have the capacity for us to make a choice before we come into existence. So in Islam, we believe that Allah is the one who has specified our characteristic. Whether a person is a male or a person is a female, whether you are a black person or you are a European or you are from the East or you are from the West, or you are within an ethnicity, whether you are Chinese or you are Indian or you are Malay, Allah is one who created all human beings, and Allah is one who specify what is your racial background, what is the color of your skin, what is the language that you speak, where you come from, and all these things. So in Islamic theology, we call it this is a takhsis, this is any specification. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He specifies His creation. Whether you are going to be in this world for 50 years, or whether you are going to be in this world for 60 years, and how much sustenance that you will receive. We Muslims, we believe that even our sustenance, our rizq, is ordained by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are people who are born in a rich family, There are people who are born in a poor family. And this is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All this is a test. That's what Allah mentioned in the Quran. هُوَ الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ. Allah created life and death to test you. So when we are in what we are, in our situation that we are in, whether we are a Malay or we are a Chinese or we are a color skin, fair color skin or dark any color skin, whether we are male or we are female, the first thing we have to acknowledge is that we are the creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah has ordained that we are such a specification or such a characteristic. So what is incumbent upon human beings, number one, is to be pleased with the ordainment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is a test. Again, this is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So let me give you a simple example, and we just go to another example, not on gender. Let us go to the issue. For example, if a person asks that why God created me in a poor family, there are certain people, for example, they are born and they are the princes, they are the sons of kings and queens. Certain people they come to this world and they found themselves being what you call it, born into a poor family, living in a favela, or living in a what you call it, a poor district or neighborhood. And people are brought up in that situation. So if a poor person asks why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make me poor, why Allah created me in such a situation, the answer is the same. We say life is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it is not about whether you are a rich person or you are a poor person, whether you are a male and whether you are a female. What is important is that how are you able to show gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and be patient to the difficulties that you are facing, and return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asking him for assistance. So that is why in Islam, the person who are the closest to Allah, the person who is loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is the person who possess the God consciousness. That the one who shows gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who has patience over the calamities and difficulties that he's facing, and the one that is returning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for returning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for assistance. So that is the person who is successful. So in Islam, there is no difference between a male and a female. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this regard mentioned in the Quran, inna akramakum indallahi atqakum. The best of you is the one who possess taqwa to Allah, the one who possess God consciousness, the one who obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who refrain from the prohibitions of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, regardless whether you are a male or you are a female. A male who is obedient to Allah is more successful than a female who is not obedient to Allah. A female who is obedient to Allah is more successful than a male who is not obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So life in this world is a test. Whatever situation that you find yourself in, when you are in this existence, we must understand that this is chosen by God. This is ordainment by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when Allah make a person a male, we have to be showing gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his will and for his ordainment, and we try our best to obey him in whatever situation that he puts us in. So again, this is a test from Allah. And from what I understand from your question, that you have undergone the MTF, transsexual post, and you are in the state of post operation, meaning you have undergone that operation. But what is important for that you have to that I just want to impart to you is that whatever it is important for us, number one, to realize our mistakes and to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it doesn't mean that in the situation that you are in, that there you are at the dead end or there is no hope for you. So we must understand that the door of repentance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is still open. We human beings we do a lot of sins. There is none of us like angels that we do not do any sin. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us kullu bani Adam khata'un. All the sons of Adam make mistakes and sins. Wa khayrul khata'in at-tawwabun. And the best of those who commit any mistakes, and the best of those who commit any sins, are the ones who return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after committing those sins, and the one who have regret upon what they have done. So what is any important for us, all of us, I need to take note that whatever sin any that we do, it is important any for us any to make repentance any to Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala. It is important for us any to have regret, and I believe any the questioner any you are having any regrets any over the mistakes any that you have done in the past. So it is important for you any to take note that the door any of repentance any of Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala is open for you. If you make tawbah and if you repent any to Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala with the conditions any of repentance. So let me just go through any with you the conditions any of this repentance. There are three. Meaning, and if you are able any to do these three things in a state any of repenting to Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala, all of your sins any will be forgiven by Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala. Imagine any to the one any who is asking any this question. Imagine you are in a state where all of your sins any are forgiven any by Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala, and I promise you that Allah any will show you the way. And if you repent any to Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala, all any of your problems, inshaAllah, by the help any of Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala, by the assistance any of Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala, all any of your problems any will be solved. And we in Masjid Khalid, yani our doors any are open. We are not saying any that we are the experts any in this field or anything, but what you call it, we can try any our best any to help. Yani if people any come any to us, for example, any in such any a situation, we have any expertise any outside any of Masjid Khalid any that we can any refer. Those any who are in this any situation any too, and we can also any provide any advice and so on and so forth. So it is important any that you seek help. It is important any that you seek help. So point number one, what I'm saying, the importance any of returning to Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala, the importance of repenting to Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala. We are still any alive, we are still given any the opportunities any by Allah. Being any alive any is a blessing any from God. Being any alive is a blessing any from God, and opportunities any are still there. The doors any to repentance any is still there. So do not any despair from the mercy of Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala. So this is any the message I would like any to pass any to the one any who is who sent any this question. I do not know any how to contact you, but this is any the means any that I can impart in this message. What I'm saying is that do not be despair from the mercy of Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala. The doors any of repentance any are still open. Yes, any we make any mistakes any in the past, but do not any be despair. Do not any be despair. Any the Satan any want any human beings any to be despair, so that human beings any go any in a state any of disbelief any to Allah. So these are the things any that we have to be careful. So when we speak any about repentance any to Allah, earlier any I mentioned there are three conditions any of repentance. And if you are able any to do these three conditions, any remember that all of your sins any will be forgiven by Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala. Number one, when we speak any about repentance, there must be regret. An-nadam. This is the most important pillar in repentance. So our scholars any they mention that a person any who is doing tawbah is not doing tawbah without regret. So if you are having any the regrets any for what you have done in the past, this is a very good sign. This is any a good sign. So having any regret any over our past sin. And number two, promise Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala not any to return any to what any we have done. And we, of course, any it's not easy to totally absolve ourselves any from the sins any that we are committing. But of at least any we make a resolution, that we make any a promise, and we try any our best in practice. And do not forget any to ask Allah for assistance any, because if we depend on our capacity, there are a lot of things any that we cannot do. But if we depend any on Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala, then Allah any will the help any of Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala. We certainly any come. So number one any is having regret. Number two is resolution. Any not any to return any to the sin. And number three is to put in efforts any to obey Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala and refrain any from the prohibitions. So if we are able any to do these three things, Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala promise any in the Quran that Allah any will forgive any the sins any of human beings whenever any make tawbah to Allah. And remember the hadith which I read and you just know, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam any mention kullu bani Adam khata'un, all of the children of Adam any they make any mistakes and sins, wa khayrul khata'in at-tawwabun, and the best any who commit any those sins are the ones any who are tawwab, the ones any who return to Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala. So this is any the solution. This is any the advice, the main advice I'm giving, and this also advice any for myself. All of us any I need any to make tawbah to Allah. As what I mentioned, any nobody any is perfect. We try any our best, yani to look any into this, to reflect any upon the importance any of returning any to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. And inshallah, any Allah mentioned in the Quran, وَمَن يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَل لَّهُ مَخْرَجًا وَيَرْزُقْهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ. Yani those any who return any to Allah, and those any who have a resolution any to obey Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, Allah yani will give him a way out. So this is what any I believe any you are looking for to the questioner and you are asking, that you are looking out any for the way out, and you are asking any about the hereafter. Yes, any there is any hereafter. There is any hereafter. We have any verses any in the Quran, the hadith any of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and there is no doubt that human beings any when they pass away, they will be reckoned by Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. There'll be questioned. So it is important any before we pass away, we have to make tawbah to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. We do not want any to pass away any in a state where we are having any all these baggages and all these sins on our shoulders. How are we able any to be any in the court of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala in the hereafter? How are we able any to recompense any for our sins? This is any the time. This is any the time. This is the opportunity that as long as we are still any alive, this is any the opportunity any for us any to change. This is any the opportunity for us to return any to Allah. Do not any be deluded any by whatever any people are saying, or do not any be deluded any by the whispers any of the devil. But we have any to be focused. We have any to be focused. Help any is there. The help any of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala is there, and Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala yani will send any His mercy as what we mentioned for those any who repent any to Allah and never ever despair from the mercy of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. And you remember this, never ever despair any from the mercy any of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. So again any going back any to the issue any of gender, some of us are male, some of us are females, these are ordinment any of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. And we as human beings any we cannot change. We cannot any change our bodies. When we are yani a male, it is not any permissible any in Islam any to change any to female, as what I mentioned. So as far as the ruling any is concerned, it is clear any in Islam that it is not any permissible any for a male to act any like a female, and a female any to act any like a male. So going back any to this question, there are certain parts any I do not really understand the question where. The question is asking, do you think in such a scenario, if I want to be a female next life, I have any to self-determinate if I know I am the male sperm? I do not any really understand what is asked any by the questioner, but I invite any the questioner any to come any to our mosque, any we can sit down and we can talk, and maybe any we can understand your situation any better. It's not any about condemning. Some people any have this misunderstanding any that we, you know, like these imams or some any of these any ustaz any are condemning the LGBT any community. Yes, any what we are condemning any, we are condemning any the sinful acts. We are condemning any the things any that are prohibited, but we are not any condemning any the people. So here we have any to differentiate any between the sin and the sinner. The sin and the sinner. And we are not any saying any that there is no way out. As what I mentioned, there is any a way out. The way out any is making tawbah to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. And we are not any saying any that those Muslims any who are in this situation we are better any than them. And we do not know. There are people from the LGBT any community any who repent to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, who return any back any to the straight path. And they change. And they are becoming good Muslims and so on and so forth. So here any we have any to understand, we have to come into a common understanding any that here we are not speaking any about whether I hate you or you hate me, or whether we are condemning certain any people within any the certain the movement and so on and so forth. But here we are trying to help. This is basically what I'm trying to say. We are laying out any the rulings any in Islam any as Muslims, but at the same time also we want to help. We want to help. So that any inshallah any our brothers and sisters can return any to Allah yani with repentance and be back any on the straight path, and we are ready inshallah ta'ala yani to give any some more advices. So I hope any it is I hope any I answered any your question, and if not any 100% maybe for most part any of it. And what is any important any again I would like any just any to close any this session any by saying any the importance any of us to be pleased with the ordainment of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. This is any a test any for some people, but this is any the test that if you are able any to overcome any this test and to understand the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in His creation, and to be pleased by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah has manifest in you, then that is your path any to success. Do not any be despair from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we have to fight any our desires, and we got no choice, and we have to fight any the whispers any of the whispers any of the devil. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of us inshallah any with tawbatan nasuha. May Allah any answer our prayers, and may Allah help any our brothers and sisters any no matter where they are around the world. That Allah any bless any the Muslims any with His mercy, with His blessings inshallah ta'ala. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us any with husnul khatimah, any a good ending. And may Allah make us any return any to Him any in a state anywhere He is pleased any with us. Amin ya rabbal alamin. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. And I think any because of time, we do not have much time any to go on any to the next question inshallah, and we postpone any the other questions to the next week any inshallah. Till then any we see you again. Alhamdulillah rabbil alamin. Allahumma salli wa sallim ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali sayyidina Muhammad. Rabbana atina fid dunya hasanah wa fil akhirati hasanah wa qina adhaban nar. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Alhamdulillah rabbil alamin. Yeah.